I would want to say thank you, O Heavenly Father, for another day's living. We thank you for awakening us this morning and closing us in our right mind and starting us on another day's journey. And this we say thank you. We come also thanking you for these that is gathered here this afternoon as we come on this call. Heavenly Father, we pray that you would put us on one accord. Give us a oneness of mind and just be with us throughout this season. And we thank you for all the blessings that you have bestowed upon us. We thank you for this season of December. We thank you for watching over us up into here in Florida. Oh, I realize that you've been gracious to us all down through this year. But I pray that you would continue to be with us as we go through this task. We thank you for this season of giving, this season of love, this season of peace, this season of joy. Realizing, oh Heavenly Father, for this cause, you send your darling son into this world. Our only Savior, Heavenly Father, for peace on this earth. And Heavenly Father, as we come, we ask you to remember those that are less fortunate than I.
Yes.
Oh, Heavenly Father, remember the homeless and the destitute. Remember those that are hungry this morning, Heavenly Father. Look in at them and trust and just touch right now.
Yes.
Oh, Heavenly Father, we just thank you in the name of Jesus. And we praise and glorify your holy name this evening.
Yes.
This is our prayer, Lord.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Thanks for coming out, everyone that's here. We are Midtown. We are Midtown. We thank you for your support. Midtown was established in 1968 during the relocation and redevelopment. And at that time, I understand Shelley was the mayor, and there was a promise made. It was home to home. There were black folk in the Fillmore that Victorians were torn down. And they said, well, don't feel bad about that. This is what we're going to do. We're going to put you right here in this beautiful property, Midtown. Midtown was an outstanding property. And again, it was own to own. There was promises made that once the mortgages paid off, that the tenants would be either outright owners or co-op. Let's fast forward to 2007. That was a resolution that was passed by the Board of Supervisors. It was voted on, and all of the supervisors signed it, signed by Gavin Newsom, that once the mortgage was paid off, which was paid off in 2007, that we would become outright owners or co-op. Right now, the city is reneging on Resolution 325-07. 2013, Midtown residents had a month-to-month lease with the city. We were unique as apartments because the property is the only apartment owned by the city of San Francisco with no subsidies. In December 2013, they called a meeting at the mayor's office of housing. They terminated our lease, and they made a sweetheart deal. Personally, I feel with Mercy Housing to let them come in and manage our property. And since they've been there, it's been nothing but problems and the treatment that they've given to the folk that live there. They're coming in treating us as if we are subsidized housing. Nothing against people that are subsidized, but we are not. And we won't stand for the treatment that we've been receiving. Some of our seniors that are no longer able to do the stairs, there are no elevators in the property, and they are requesting to move from the second and third floors to the first floor. Mercy stated that if you get a letter from your doctor stating that if you have to move to the first floor, you have to pay market rate. That is not fair. That is downright. Downright. Treacherous. So that's why we're here, to let Mercy know that we're not going to stand for it. We're going to stand up for our rights. We are going to be owners of Midtown Park Apartment. And it's been stated publicly, if the property is not given to us, it's being stolen from us. Outright thievery. So right now, now I'm going to have a speaker, Pastor Gorham from the Bayview, to come forward and share some words. All right, Pastor Gorham, everybody.
Hello, Midtown. For our lives. We are in a fight for our lives. Our very existence depends upon being able to own our property and our land. There is no coincidence that they want to subsidize instead of allowing us to own. Because if we own, then we have control. And now we see the big picture. We need to own where we live. They promised the slaves 40 acres and a mule. I don't have 40 acres, and I don't have no mule. But I do have the right to the pursuit of happiness. And I want to stay in San Francisco. The African-American population is down to 3%. They know that if we get subsidy, they can kick us out whenever they want. That's the reason why we have to really fight to own where we stay. I want my stake in the ground. And I'm telling you today that I'm here to fight with you and for you. Keep the fight alive. Mercy Housing, they need to get out of there and leave the citizens of Midtown alone. Let them do their own. They have the capacity to do what they need to do. Allow them to do that. That's all we ask. That's all we ask. And so we're here to fight with you. And I want you to know that whatever you call, I'm here for you.
Thank you.
Thank you so very much for your support. At this time, we're going to ask the Archbishop King to come forth and share some words with us.
All power to the people.
Yes!
All power to the people. Yes! The people's power is getting stronger by the hour. I'm so pleased to be able to stand with you today and voice my feelings and opinions about things. You know, it's a doggone shame that they would call this Mercy Housing.
Yes!
It's almost like Fillmore, what they call it, redevelopment, rather than Negro removal.
Yeah.
If this is about mercy, then let mercy take its place. The Pope, the Archbishop, and the Catholic, Roman Catholic Church should be ashamed of themselves to be involved in the killing of the people's dreams and actually robbing and stealing property. See, it's going on all over the city, but the Roman Catholic Church should not be involved in this. We know that the mayor from one generation to the next has been involved in persecuting black, brown, and poor people. Do we have to bring up the history of the Roman Catholic Church and say this is the way they've been carrying on for the last 2,000 years? They made enough money off of slavery. They don't need to do this. Except that they got a greedy, bloody kind of attitude. A disrespect for people that are poor. So I'm just going to say this to the Archbishop of this diocese. You need to get involved, brother.
Oh, yes!
Find out what's really going on here. Mayor Lee, you know we already dogging your trail because you haven't taken care of your business like you should. Murders taking place in the streets. You're not raising up. This is akin to murder.
Yeah.
You know, when we were in the at the heat of the foreclosure, an illegal eviction movement with AIDS, one of the things that we said that, you know, we would rather deal with Al Capone than banks. Well, we'd rather deal with Al Capone and some gangsters rather than dealing with Mercy Housing. a fight that is consistent. In other words, this ain't the first time that we have to come down here. We're going to have to come down here, and we got to double our numbers every time we come down here. We got to keep dogging the trail. And let me just say the mercy. See, mercy, the word mercy is unearned favor and grace from God. It's not something that you have to jockey for or work for. It's just a gift from God. Now, if you're going to call yourself mercy, then there should be some favor and some grace for the people who are standing on a rightful position. We're not asking you to do something illegal. We're just asking you to do the right thing.
The right thing.
Can you do the right thing? If not, change your name and go ahead and be the crooks and the dogs and the wolves that you are. And stop pretending to be the folks that are about mercy, because there's no mercy. All power to the people. With love to all. God bless you. Love to bring.
All right.
And right now we have our attorney to come forth.
Yay!
And then after our attorney comes forth, we're going to ask Stubb Shoemaker to come up and see if he can share some words about mercy that has no mercy.
Come on, Don, come on to us. Blame yourself.
Now, usually, when lawyers start talking, people start snoozing because they realize they're going to have a bit of time. But I'm going to try and not do that. What I am doing at this time is trying to make the city abide by the rules. Until the issue that's the bigger issue we're talking about here, which is who owns or should own the property. In the meantime, the city is trying to say that they want to wear two hats. They want to be both the owners of the property, that is to say the landlord, and they want to say that they're exempt from rent control because, well, it's government regulated. Well, it's only government regulated because they own it and they're saying the rates. Now, that is contrary to both the letter and the spirit of the law. And unfortunately, the rent board was not able to see that, but then again, the rent board works for the mayor. And it's really difficult to get somebody to go against their boss. I understand that. But one of the things we got in this country still is an independent judiciary. And we are filing this week in San Francisco Superior Court to ask an independent judge to review this and to see that, well, the dispute about the ownership of Midtown is resolved, that the rent control ordinance should, does, and will apply to these people's homes and their lives. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you so very much. I want you to look around. This is not only Midtown. These are friends of Midtown. We have a local 214, Letter Carrier Union, the Unified School District. The teachers have supported us. San Francisco Labor Council. These are our supporters. We're not standing our own. That's and we're going to fight.
I'll tell you now.
Thank you.
Sure. How you doing?
I say, what do we want? You say ownership. What do we want?
Ownership.
And when do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Ownership.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Ownership.
When do we want it?
Okay, I better get
I'm staying with
it. Oh, yeah, but I'm staying with
it. It's different from our
narrative. Not
all right. Okay, what I'd like to do is ask, we have our friend Maria from representing Plaza 16 in Santa Rosa.
There's a lot of things going on here. But I think at the end of the day, the situation is incredibly simple. Will the Midtown tenants get to stay in their homes or not? Right?
Yes.
And here we are to say that the Midtown residents will stay in their homes. Will you all stay in your homes?
Yes.
Will you all be moved?
No.
That's right. And so we know that the housing crisis is astronomical. To ask tenants to move out of affordable housing that is affordable to them into this incredibly competitive rental market is unconscionable.
Yes.
Murder.
It is.
Murder.
It is being a bad neighbor. It is acting in bad faith. So, Plaza 16 is here because we see in the mission the incredible loss of working class Latino community. We see the incredible loss of our communities of color that have built our neighborhoods, and we're fighting against that. And so we're here to stand in solidarity with Midtown tenants, who are also fighting to keep working class residents, black residents, in the Fillmore, in the part of San Francisco that you all have helped create.
Yes.
The fact that San Francisco is down to 3% of its black population is a crime.
Right.
Yeah. The fact that we continue to let the police shoot and murder our members of our communities is a crime.
Yes.
And the fact that the city is doing some sort of deal to put people out of their homes, black folks, Latino folks, working class folks, well, people of color out of their homes, that is also a crime.
Yes.
And so, here, we're fighting market redevelopments in the mission that are pushing our communities out. We're also fighting the city. We're trying to make sure that the city knows what the priorities and what the investment needs to be. And in Midtown and in Fillmore and in the Western Addition, we know that the fight is not the same, but it's similar. And we're here to stand in solidarity with you because everybody deserves safe, affordable housing, a roof over their head. And the thing is that when we say housing is a human right, it's not just a chant. We're not just saying it's safe. It's real, and having housing makes it so we can have stable neighborhoods and communities. So Plaza 16 is here with Midtown tenants, because the Midtown tenants will not be moved.
Yeah.
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 All right. Thank you very much, Maria. We do appreciate that. You know what? Business and stay your life, choices. Local mission to Western Addition, it doesn't matter where you live, because all of us are being affected by the greedy developers.
Yeah.
What's really mind-boggling is when a developer
lies to the media down there right now. Let's go down there.
Why does he have to go all the way down there to tell his lies?
All right.
Why can't we have it, sir?
What happens if you
There have been no efforts to evict anyone. There has been no legal action taken against anyone, okay, to address the concerns that are out there. If people come to us with things that they're concerned about, like this couple, and I'm sorry I don't know your individual story, we take them to either address the individual situation, or if it really looks like something that we don't understand correctly, we change the policy, and that's happened numerous times.
Okay, can I ask a question? Okay. Our understanding is that the mortgage was paid off, okay? There's no longer a mortgage on the property. Is that not your fault?
Okay, so the city owns this property, right? The city has been subsidizing the operations and the physical repairs of the property. So whether the city has a loan on the property or not, I believe that there isn't one.
Was that money allocated for subsidizing?
I don't know anything about
it. What happened to the solution 325-07? That basically lays out the roadmap towards ownership of the Midtown property by the tenant.
It says very clearly what's supposed to happen, and I wasn't involved in the process, but the San Francisco Community Land Trust and Bernal Heights spent, I believe, 2 or 3 years working with the resident council on a plan for a co-op that was ultimately determined not to be feasible, not by Mercy Housing, okay? And we stepped in afterwards because it was clear that was not going to be working.
Okay, well,
I just want to be really clear that we are totally willing to work with all of you in a calm and reasonable fashion to talk about any of these things. And we've made that really clear. I just sat down the other day with Pat. I met you for the first time, and I said we are totally willing to spend.
One of the things we spoke about was this couple. I didn't bring their names up. These are the people that can't go to the office and get respect unless they bring someone else, unless they bring Donald with them, unless they bring someone else with them, because they're just sort of pushed aside and told to go home and don't worry about it.
Okay.
You know, these are not okay things. People get addicted to threats. They're not eviction notices. When you're bombarded with eviction threats day in, day out, it does not create a calm atmosphere.
That is harassment.
It does not create a calm atmosphere.
I appreciate what you're saying.
Okay, we got a resident, and we mentioned this the other day. He's over 80 years old. He's had business issues. He's now in the hospital. They're not releasing him because he can't get a bedroom or one bedroom downstairs. And we have them available, but you know what? I won't say you personally, but whoever you have in charge is not allowing this man to come home from the hospital to die at home, essentially.
And as I said to you when we met on Friday, like, if you give me the name of that person, I will follow up immediately.
Jose LaCrosse.
Thank you.
Everybody knows
Jose LaCrosse.
Jose LaCrosse.
Jose LaCrosse.
Jose LaCrosse.
He's a pillar of this community.
That's right.
I don't plan to come home. Oh,
the Gilmore. 92 years old. Have to walk up 40 stairs. 92
years old. But we sent us on to London. We feel that we're all liars.
Well, I just spoke to Supervisor Reed this morning. I don't think that's her opinion of this issue at all.
But I hear this
off.
What it sounds like
with
community is that the mortgage was paid off. If I paid off my mortgage, and then whoever owned the mortgage said, well, we screwed up, and the property actually belongs to somebody else, and now, even though you paid off your mortgage, I'm going to come in, and you have to pay 30% of our income. That doesn't make any sense.
Listen, I'm not going to sit here and try and explain back a misrepresentation of what I think happened. I am totally happy to sit down and talk with the residents of Midtown and figure out exactly what we need to do going forward. That's our commitment. It's been our commitment from the very beginning. But I can't sit here and respond to every misrepresentation of fact. The city owns the property, not Mercy Housing. Okay.
Mercy just needs to step out of the way so that Midtown residents can fulfill their dream of ownership. They just need to step away and be gone. We do not want them. There is not a single resident in Midtown, aside from one or two maybe, who are just completely lost their damn mind, who want Mercy to remain.
Okay, well,
who in their right mind would want that? We don't want you guys. It's time for you to go. Mercy has a Midtown. Mercy has a Midtown. Mercy has a Midtown. Mercy has a Midtown. Midtown. Mercy has a Midtown.
Mercy has a Midtown.
Okay, the unit to that permission. There is a lady, she's 65 years old. She calls me, crying, says, Jay,
somebody came in into my house. I was taking a bath. I came out in a nightgown. I saw two mass employees standing inside. I was shocked. I said, why are you here? Well, we gave you a notice we can enter. She said, I never responded to that. She had a safety chain lock on. They cut it. They cut the safety chain lock and they entered the unit of this lady. Now this man is gonna stand here and say this is a misrepresentation. This is a story. Listen, if that was true, I don't think anybody of us would have been here. I've got better things to do. Father 16's got better things to do. Other organizations got better things to do at that time. There is a wrong and there is a right. And if you cannot see the difference, we cannot help you. We cannot help you. But what I would like to do is, I would like to ask my friend Alan Benjamin, on behalf of the San Francisco Labor Union, to say a couple of words, and then we're going to close off with a prayer.
Thank you, sisters and brothers. You know, we've seen this in the labor movement, the hard cops and the soft cops. They're able to carry out the evictions. They're able to carry out their crimes by contracting out. What have they done? They put the human face, mercy housing. The soft talk, we want to sit down and work out with you your individual case here and there. And they might, in order to get you to swallow the bitter pill, in order to get you to accept the unacceptable, which is drive you out of your homes, your rightful homes, you paid off the mortgages, and to do what they are continuing to do in this city, turn it into the city of the rich, the elite, the whites only. Black and brown people have to be gone. Oh, yes, you can come in and clean our cities and commute for an hour and a half to get here and get paid a miserable wage. But no, self-determination, forget it. Right to own your home, forget it. We in the labor movement have to say no. I'm happy to tell you that the United Educators of San Francisco adopted a resolution that has two questions that were taken up. In the interim, rent control, no evictions, and ownership is ultimately what has to happen, has to come back. And if mercy wants to show mercy, get out of the way, hands off, and turn it over back to the community that owns these properties. That's the right thing to do. That's the only thing that mercy can do. Tonight we have the meeting of our San Francisco Labor Challenge. And you know why it's going to be a challenge? Because they're smart. They haven't been ruling for all this time and evicting us because they're stupid. They've got us divided. They've got people in our own council saying, well, you know, it's complicated. Well, you know, they're people who haven't paid their rent for who knows how long. But they're people who've been squatting. I don't know what all stories I've heard. All with one goal, to get us to be divided and to ultimately let them impose 30% or whatever it is, it's eviction. It's the fast line to eviction.
Yes.
And we know that, my God, 3% in this city, Western Edition, which we should have all, the labor movement fell asleep at the wheel. Finally, we have a challenge. It's not going to be easy. We're very proud that Jay, that Phil, and Sister Mary Watson are going to be with us tonight. And we're going to have a discussion. I'm sure Mercy might be there as well. And we're going to have the same discussion. And hopefully we will prevail. If not today, it'll be tomorrow. Because rest assured, those of us who want to see labor stand with Black Lives Matter, with Black Homes Matter, with Black and Brown Lives Matter, who want to see justice prevail, we are not going to stop. We are not going to relent until Midtown Parts gets its home, until you all get that deal that was promised to you, until that is codified, put in writing, and you are back in your homes, and that you can preserve the 3% and expand the 3%. We're not going to let the 1% throw you out. Thank you, sisters and brothers.
Thank you. All right.
our continuous fight for a number of years, we have enjoyed a very fruitful relationship with our friends and family in Bayview and Hunter's Point. We have uncles, our brothers and sisters, going through some dark times. And I was lucky enough to have met Grace Martinez from ACE, who has been organizing there for decades. And I would like to hear a couple of words from Grace.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
Whose city is this?
Our city.
Whose city?
Our city.
I've heard a lot of people talk about how everyone's reason for not supporting this is because it's complicated. You know what's complicated? Being uprooted from your own city that you helped build. And that's the problem, is that anyone who is not on our side is in the way. So what are we going to fight for? We're going to fight to stay. Are we fighting to stay?
Yeah.
Well, one thing that ACE definitely is going to support Midtown 100% and towards the end, another thing is that where is their emergency right now? Their emergency is at your door. But where do we need to take their emergency?
To their door.
To their door. This Saturday, we are going to the mayor's house because Christmas is disrupted because there's an eviction hanging over our heads. Where should the eviction occur? Mayor's house. We're meeting at Glen Park Park Station this Saturday, December 19th at 4 p.m. We want everyone from Midtown to go there and to make their demand. Because this isn't just about Mercy Housing. It's about the city refusing to work with tenants here. If we were the Ron Conways, the developers, the tech people, how quickly would we get our houses back? But because we are the working class, because we are the last 3%, because we are people of color, they don't care. And what's coming up, and this is all being displaced because of the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
You
mean the Stupid Bowl.
The Stupid. So whose city is this?
Ours.
Whose city?
Ours.
All right, thank you, Grace. I'm here too. We're definitely going to be there. We will definitely pay Mayor Lee a visit. Now, a long-time community leader, Beth Smith, a young lady who has raised scores of kids, her own, and foster adopted children that I feel privileged to live on the same floor that I see on a daily basis, who feels very passionate about this because this is her home. She'd like to say a couple of words.
Hey, you know what? You should tell them to bring a thing of coal. Everyone that goes to the mayor's house, bring a lump of coal for the president. Wipe it in a bowl.
45 years. I stayed there because of the promise of ownership. I was told initially that these were rent to own. And that's why I came to Midtown. I've seen this over and over in flyers from way back then, 68, 67, about the promise that Midtown gave to the people in the community. I was moved out of my home on Eddy. I didn't own the home, so I didn't get a certificate, but I was given a paper that I could move back in, that I could move back in with priority. And I chose Midtown. Midtown was not subsidized. My rent at that place in 1969 was $71 up the street from Midtown. When I moved to Midtown, it was $182 because I wanted to live in this grand place that cost way more than mine did, but I wanted to live there. It was wonderful, you know, and the city owned it ultimately. We had to find that out when things started going wrong at Midtown. We had to dig through the paper to find out who actually owns this place because management companies were taking care of us. We found out it was the city. So then the city, then we had to come and knock on their door any number of times to ask for things to be repaired. They're the absentee landlords. If there's anything wrong with Midtown right now, it's because the city made it that way. The city neglected to do anything to keep us up with whatever we needed to be kept up with, our boilers, our rooms, or whatever. I've been moved to 3 different apartments because of mold and mildew, because of bad rooms or what have you. That heaters or what, all these different things. And yes, I have raised many children in Midtown. I have children right there now at my senior age that I am raising that are autistic and they have mental disabilities and everything else. But so in answer to that, what I said earlier, that somebody's going around saying people at Midtown are lazy, I beg to differ. I'm still working every day. And also with the situation with the Jose La Crosby, an 80 some 75-year-old man who owned businesses in the Fillmore, who's owned this. I watched him last year go to work every day on the bus, over 80. He is not lazy. He's in the hospital now, and he has to stay there until somebody can move him onto the first floor, because he's not allowed by the doctors to go up and down those stairs, because we don't have elevators that we've been accused of wrecking our own elevators. We don't even have elevators. So I don't know what they're talking about. But anyway, I say this to say we are here. We're staying here. We're going to fight until the end. Where else do we go? Where else do we go?
That's right. All right, sister. Thank you. And then we'll do a test, and we're going to ask Manzel to give us a prayer. We'll do a nice group shot, because I think the mercy is going to put something else. So let's do a nice group shot in front of the office.
Yeah.
Let's let them know that unless they do the right thing, oh, we're going to be back. We're going to be back. My enemy is necessary to say no.
Hi, I'm a resident of Midtown. I've lived at Midtown for 34 years. I have worked for the San Francisco Giants in stadium operations. I ran the second largest municipality in the country, which is San Francisco Parking Meter Revenue Collection. I've designed the parking meters, the containers they use now, the security system. I am not delusional. They told us we were going to be able to buy our home once we paid off the mortgage, and now they're rescinding that because of the wealth that they can make between Kaiser, that's it, and other building organizations that want to come in and use up every spot that we have available in San Francisco for housing that is not affordable to us. Even the one on Gary, which is supposed to be affordable housing, is $3,000 for a one-bedroom unit. So I don't know what they're talking about as affordable, but Midtown Park has been dedicated and was irrevocably dedicated to us when they took our million-dollar home from Pine, California, and Bush Street to expand the street. And then they took our homes, and then they gave us vouchers, and then they told us, oh, well, the Board of Supervisors came and said, well, you can't just take their homes and give them nothing. So then they put us at Midtown. And not in the 34 years that I've been there have they ever asked me what my income was, level, that I told me I couldn't make a certain amount of money. And now all of a sudden they bring in Mercy, who was there before us, you know, that came in before and worked with us at our management company for Midtown. Now they're back with their own lease. No one told us that. No one said, well, do you want to stay here with Mercy and become low income or moderate income? No one said that. No one said, this is the terms that you're going to have to deal with this lease. The Board of Supervisors didn't bring it to our attention, didn't let us speak on it, didn't talk to us about it. We woke up one morning and Mercy was our landlord. And now they're trying to say that we want to be disgruntled. Of course we're disgruntled. We've been there for 30-something years with the promise that this would be our home, and all of a sudden we wake up and we're less than tenants. They treat us worse than housing, public housing, when they want you to tell them who's sleeping in your house at night. You can't walk to the wash house without wearing shoes, like I need you to tell me that. And you have to pack, you can't even back your car in, you got to pull it forward. Little things like that, just harassing. Every time we come home, we have to worry about, is there a sign under the door, a message telling us that we're going to be kicked out for one reason or another. This is harassment. We've had one woman who lived there. She had mold. They moved her into an apartment, which was like a hotel apartment. She had just finished fighting cancer. And then one of the tenants went to find and talk to her, and they found her dead in her unit. Now, this is because of Mercy. So if you're trying to say that Mercy's not causing us harm, it's not hurting us, we've had people, and then also Jose, like they say, who's been a pillar of our community, had businesses in the Fillmore, on the Visadero, and now he can't come home. He's a veteran. He served his country. He cannot come home because Mercy wants him to sign a lease before they move him down to the first floor. So I don't know who's saying that Mercy is not harming us, is not harassing us, is not trying to put us out. That's a lie. And like I said, I'm not delusional.
That's
you
right.
know, I run a business. I live in San Francisco. I've lived in San Francisco all my life. And this is a community that I love. Midtown are people I love. This is my family. This is a community that has that still go to church, where children still say yes, ma'am, no, ma'am. We need to make more of the city like Midtown, not less. And
that's
I love
right.
these people, and we need to stop and fight for our homes and let Mercy know, no, we don't look at you as a tyrant, but we do know that you know that this was not a good deal. And we know that you know that these people are being abused and misused. So we need the mayor to come out and talk to us, give us 30 minutes like we have, and let's talk. Because we paid the mortgage out, you promised us, and you need to stick by your word.
That's right.
All right, thank you. And District 5 is a very progressive district. Very progressive district. Now, all we have is our good friend, Tess, from the D5 Action Group. She's going to share a couple of words. You know, when we say that we're not delusional, we know that we were promised our homes. Folks like her come out and speak in our support because she knows that we're not crazy. I didn't just dream it up like Dr. Shoemaker is saying.
Thank you. My God!
Friends and neighbors, Tess Wellborn, D5 Action. We have to work together. They're trying to change the city and take out all the people who are at 100% of area income and replace us all with high-income folks. And Midtown is a case in point. We have to work together. And Mercy is definitely not a bad actor here, but you know who they worked for? It's the mayor's office of housing. And don't forget it. And that's where we have to take the next battle to is the mayor's office of housing is trying to shove high rises into San Francisco, and Mercy is helping them in that respect. Midtown is a great site. They can see 6 to 10 story buildings at that
That's
site.
That's right.
So fight, keep fighting for your homes, and we neighbors will be fighting with you.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Ted. I would like to thank everybody for coming. Our long-term supporters, Clause 16, our folks from Anti-Eviction Mapping Project, our wonderful Save Midtown Support Committee, our friends and neighbors from the Bayview, from Hunter's Point, they came out to spend some time with us and hear about why are we fighting, why is this happening. Now what I'd like to do is let's all go take a large group picture right in front of the Mercy.
Yes. Come on.
Right. It's very secure in
June.
Uh-huh.
This will be on YouTube in a couple of days.
Mayor Lee wanted to have pay 30% of your income because that's the
4%.
Last 3%. Last 3%. Last 3%.